Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, what you're seeking here determines the hereafter. Lay not treasures for yourself upon this earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do break through and steal. But lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Matthew chapter 6, 19 through 21. We are in a world that tells a one you must have it before you die. The rich young man in the book of Matthew went away sorrowful because he could not let go of his earthly treasure for the heavenly. In verse 16, he came and asked, what must he do to have eternal life? Everybody wants to live forever. Ask most people and they will tell you. They want to look young and beautiful. They don't want to grow old and die. But let us look at the Lord's response to the young man. The Lord told him to keep his commandments. The young ruler answered back in all truth. However, the next question would prove to be very difficult. The Lord told him to sell his possession, give it to the poor, by the which he would be laying up treasures for himself in heaven. Then come and follow him. But the scripture said he went away sorrowful. He could not release his treasure here on earth to receive the heavenly reward. Sometimes we sit back and wonder, what is the use? The evil ones get richer and we get poorer. It seems the harder we try to gain a little ground, we seem to just fall back. Not necessarily in all areas of finance, but we could be the ones who can't give up the things that keeps us from doing his will. The disciples knew that the Lord had something special for them. But the question is, what about us? We should never worry about the things in this world. God takes care of his own. In verse 31 and 32, the scripture reminds us, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or whether shall we be clothed? For all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that he have need of all these things. Let me say this. This might seem a little bit weird, but personally, I don't pray about clothes. I rarely do pray about food. The reason is, the scripture reminds me that God knows already that I need these things. Now, this is not a law or a commandment saying that you should do the same, but this is where my faith is, that if I'm going to do God's work, I need to look good while doing it. And not only that, it's a bit difficult to be doing all this work on an empty stomach. So I believe God knows, as a good father, how to provide. We need to learn to depend on him first and foremost, and he will take care of us. Worrying does not add to the situation, but it detracts from it. Worrying is nothing more than faith on vacation. I was so touched a few Sundays ago, a young sister at my church, Sister Amoy, who because of her job, she was not able to come to church. She tried to get her Sundays off, but it proved very difficult. Now, this is not for the faint of heart. This is for the faith of heart. She made a decision that though she needed a job and needed the money, she was not going to allow anything to stop her from being able to come to church. And so by faith, she came to church and left the job. Now, somebody might be saying that's madness. And trust me, you'd be right. Because how I define faith is madness. What she did was no different from Peter stepping out and walking on water. That young sister was able to testify just Sunday that she's now in a better paying job. And now she has her weekends off. To God be the glory. I'm not saying that everybody needs to just go around and quitting their job and lay around waiting for God to drop a house or a car in your lap. What I'm saying is, invest in the kingdom of God and his church with your time and your finances. Then you'll be laying up treasures in heaven. God is coming again. Let us be caught doing his will. Child of God, keep trying. Never quit. The only failure in life is quitting. Revelation 22 verse 12 says, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according as his work shall be. What you seek while on this earth will help to determine where you spend your eternity. The thought of the day, worrying is nothing more than faith on vacation. God bless you today in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.